Eventually, let me give you a few cases where usually you do need to run experiments. I will show them in order of how I would prioritize their importance based on my experience. Okay, the first example, when you almost always will need an A/B test, is when you run something extremely different from industry best practices. Best practices are best practices because they work the best, right? Your business could be the exception, that's true. But just in case, it's worth it to A/B test it. If you run Facebook ads where your whole creative is one color fill, it might be great and it might be terrible, so test it. If you send out a newsletter with a shocking subject line, something like, I messed this up, it might come off well or weird, so it's better to test it too. Or if you have a super animated website that's spinning and zooming, yeah, it might be interesting in some cases, but maybe a more static, more ordinary website would do a better job in terms of conversions, so you should test that too. If you have something extremely different from industry best practices, run an A/B test. The second most important situation when you will have to run an A/B test is when you want to change something that's already successful. In other words, when you take a real risk. I've already thought about this in the previous videos, but let me give you just one last example. In early 2019, I A/B tested my flagship course's landing page. This flagship course brought in roughly 40% of Data36's total revenue in 2019, so yes, I definitely had something to lose when changing the landing page for it. Also, the new variation that I came up with was something that I wasn't 100% comfortable with at that time. My original version that I knew that works already was 1,500 words long, and it had two videos embedded in it. In total, it took around 7 or 8 minutes for a potential course participant to go through it. The new variation was something that a professional copywriter recommended to write an even longer, extremely detailed landing page instead. It became 4,000 words long, and I've embedded 4 videos in it. In total, it was around 25 to 30 minutes for a reader to go through it, and I was afraid that people don't want to spend that much time reading the course description, so my conversion rate would drop. But I set up the experiment, and luckily, the professional copywriter was right and I was wrong. My conversion rate nearly doubled. I've written a short case study about this A/B test, so if you are interested, read more about it, find the link below this video, but the point is that if you want to change something that already works well, you will have to A/B test it. The third thing that it's worth it to A/B test is based purely on my experience, but I've seen the very same pattern at all the different companies I've worked with over the years, and whether we are talking about an online advertisement or a sales page, I found this. For lower priced products that people impulse buy, it's worth experimenting with images. That makes sense, because impulse buying is an emotional decision, and images influence emotions. These are usually cheaper products, for instance, cheaper clothing, cheaper cosmetics, or even cheaper subscription plans, like inspirational newsletters with a monthly price of $7 or so. So if you have a business like that, try to A/B test your images. On the other hand, for high-priced products, it's worth it to test the sales copy first, just as I have done for my $497 online course. When you sell an expensive product, you can expect people to make a rational decision. For that, you should try to help them by writing more comprehensive product descriptions, so they can evaluate your offer from every aspect, and so they can make a good decision. Of course, there are exceptions on both sides. For instance, people tend to pay for summer vacations or for cars, both can be extremely expensive, based on emotions and not always rationally. The fourth thing you might always want to A/B test is first user experience. While people encounter your website, product, or brand for the first time, they make up their mind really quickly about whether they like you or not. Thus, it's worth spending time to optimize that first user experience. Remember how I A/B tested the name of this course? That was an A/B test of that first impression as well. Speaking of which, you will want to run A/B tests when you start something new. The name of this course is a good example here as well, but also remember how Tim Ferriss A/B tested the name of his book, The 4-Hour Workweek, with Google Ads before he published it. And finally, low-hanging fruits. If you are in business for a longer time, most probably you have a long list of ideas that you want to A/B test. If you don't, no worries. Later in the course, I will show you the research framework that will help you to find and collect all those low-hanging fruits in your business. So when you have optimized all the big things that I mentioned before, you can take the list of these smaller, yet sometimes very promising low-hanging fruits and A/B test them all one by one. Okay, so these were the cases where you usually have to run A/B tests.